Good evening. Thank you for coming. And it's a wonderful experience for me to work with both Asko Schönberg and the Dream Unfinished Ensemble. Two countries united together to create this program for you tonight. And what you just heard is The Lost Garden. It's a very personal piece for myself. And it was a lost paradise in some way I could never find. But it always remained in here for me. So I'm very humbly happy to share that with you. And the next piece, in a very different way, is a public piece. And it was a collaboration with three ensembles from Europe, London Sinfonietta, Asko Schönberg, and Ensemble Modern. They want me to create this project, a piece that could connect with people, could connect audience with a performer as well. So through that journey, actually, I created two resonant theaters, and the Sonic Great War is the first one, and the second one, I also wrote it for Asko Schönberg, is called Woven, which involve heartbeat monitors, monitoring audience and performers in live feed with speakers playing back while music's performing, and then we have heartbeats to show how audience and performer affected their heart rate throughout the performance with different location, different intensity of sound, how they affected people. But at the end, we mixed it all up to show that we are all actually the same. So, and the both pieces has the idea of to blur the barrier between everybody. And for the Sonic Great War, when I got the assignment, I was thinking, well, what are the things really divided people? And war is one thing came to my mind, and this was a pro-2016 era. And and I thought of, if I find this war, and how could I turn that into a positive thing? And how do I break it, but also use it as a tool or a way to communicate with people? So I thought of a great example, several thousand years example from ancient China, the Great War. And with the Great War, aside from being a fortress, miles, many, many miles long, but also when they lit up the watchtower one by one with fire, actually, people far, far away, they could see that as a warning signal to people. So when they see that, they know, okay, to go to support. So in that sense, it also was the largest communication method years ago. So inspired by that metaphor, I use music as fire to communicate, and musician as the thread to connect the dots. So as you can see, we have six stations here. They resembling six towers. And you are sitting facing each other to create a path. And throughout the performance, the musicians will walk in front of you. And also, I need you to engage in this piece as well. That's a very important component. So in a way, I would need you to take out a piece of paper now, which you have. So it tells you which path you are. So there will be five paths. Okay. Now we might need, okay, that's good. We might need one more person or two sit on the, here. Maybe, thank you. Okay, we have a volunteer. Yeah, we would need to make sure the sound is balanced. So, okay, so what I would love you to do is, you have a pen, and on the side has your path number. Please write down a few thoughts of what is your first reaction when you think of the word war. What is your first reaction, and what is your feeling or, you know, what do you want to say about it? I mean, the beauty about this piece is throughout, hopefully in the future, people will feel differently. So be honest about what you feel about this word. I mean, could be good, could be bad, doesn't matter. different person has different opinion. So please write a few thoughts on this paper. And please write it in a way clearly, okay? And so that people could read it, okay? If you are done, please pass the paper to your neighbor or someone in your section that you can exchange with. So please go ahead to read other person's thoughts. And now, here is the fun part. Please choose one word and one word only from what you see and what you read, which affects you the most or you feel is the most meaningful word that you can put on the other side of this paper in large print, like what I show you here. Okay? Because other people need to see it when you are holding it. So please make it dark and clear in capital letters so that people could see it. One word, just one word from what you read. Pick one word and wrote it out, that word. Yeah. Okay. You know, I've done this piece in different countries. We always have different audiences, different culture. So it's fascinating for me to also to experience that as well. Okay, must be something quite humorous going on there. Okay, great, we can't wait to hear that. So, okay, so what you need to do is, now, you will have musicians walking in front of you. Now, only the first three paths, okay? Or the first three musicians walking in front of the first three paths, please hold, whisper the page, the side has many words, okay? You whisper louder, but don't speak it. So like, whisper, yeah? So now, when they start walking slowly, you start whisper. When they're walking towards you, you could whisper louder. And when they leave you, you whisper softer. So that for them also is a listening experience. So they have this sound following them throughout, okay? So so you are the performer in that sense. And once they reach the other side, and that's the signal, you can stop whispering. So they come, you whisper, they leave, you stop. Okay, so for only these three paths, one, two, and three, you whisper. Now, for the remaining musicians, when they show up, okay, that's path four and path five, and then one, two, three will have other people come again. So at that time, I want you to hold the other side of the paper, hold out so that other people could see it, and I want each person to read out what other people wrote. Okay, just read out. Now, the musicians will hear your reading to react to it with their playing, okay? And you could choose what you hear also to pick the words you want to read. And hopefully what you read could create some kind of abstract mosaic of, you know, a collage of things, okay? So again, the first three musicians, you whisper. All the rest, you create your own line, okay? With your words, all right? Are we clear? Okay, good, thank you. So, The last part I would love to invite you to participate is at the beginning of the piece, I will, and also at the end of the piece, I will invite you to join together to hum. Okay, to hum. Now, at the beginning, the first part of the piece, when you are humming, there will be a point where I will have you stand up and hum. Okay, and there will be a point you can stop. And that point is when you hear the violin and the Tibetan bow hitting like a trend coming sound. Okay, could we demonstrate that part? Violin come. Okay. It's like the trend is coming, okay? Then that's the part you can feel free to sit down and continue with the piece without humming, okay? And at the end of the piece, once you hear musicians start humming, and I would give you a big signal, and you can also join in again, okay? So that's the end of the piece, okay? Any question before we start? You might lose your chance if you don't ask now, okay? And it's your fault if you don't get it. Thank you all, good sports, we will start. Hello, yes. Now, may I invite all of you, please stand up. Feel comfortable, please stand up. I want to start a meditation with all of you. Now, please close your eyes. Just imagine you are in a place, not the National Sawdust. There are no one next to you, there are no chairs, no table, there's no walls. You are in this space, and you are taking a deep breath and breathing in and breathing out. Can you feel the distance? Can you hear your own breathing? Can you hear your own body? If you can feel your internal sound, please join me to naturally hum a low note. That's the sound of your body.
Thank you.